So that's why I would.
You're going to vote for Hillary Clinton?
I didn't say
I said I would. Is that because you think she's easier to beat?
No, it's because right now I think anybody is better than Obama.
What is that about? O'Donnell also boosted Hillary's handling of the WikiLeaks scandal. I think she may be the only one in the country twisted enough to see people in the State Department looking especially good in this thing.
He's hardly someone from whom we need to take advice about what Hillary Clinton ought to be doing.
Anything you've seen in the documents, Fran, that suggests maybe it's controversial, maybe it's pushing the limits, but is there anything you've seen in the documents that suggests the United States government is doing something illegal?
Absolutely not. And frankly, this is what diplomats do. They collect information about our allies and our friends and our enemies around the world. And by the way, while he's criticizing Secretary Clinton, he might as well include Condi Rice and Colin Powell and Madeleine Albright, all the prior secretaries of state. This isn't new. This is what
standard
our diplomats
operating
do.
Procedure.
That's right.
Okay.
What do you think of this guy? I mean, what do you think of what he's done? And I mean, his comments today about Hillary Clinton. What do you make of him?
I think he's delusional. I think, you know, good intentions, if you can even acknowledge he has good intentions, are not an excuse for breaking the law on a grand scale. And the idea that he is doing this to further the cause of peace when he is undermining negotiations that we have around the world is just preposterous. You know, I think all of us who are journalists have a kind of instinctive sympathy for whistleblowers. We rely on people for leaks. But this is so extravagant and so absurd, and his claims about Hillary Clinton are so ridiculous that, he is well beyond sympathy from anyone I'm aware of.
It's the whistleblowing website that's rocked the U.S. government by releasing hundreds of thousands of secret documents, first on the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan, and this week, diplomatic communications. And there's tremendous concern right now about other secrets WikiLeaks might possess that have yet to be released. Joining us now here in the Situation Room, Congressman Pete Hoekstra, Republican of Michigan. He's the ranking member of the House Intelligence Committee. How do you stop WikiLeaks right now from releasing more information?
I think it's next to impossible. I don't think there is a way to stop WikiLeaks, The Guardian, Der Spiegel, or The New York Times from making anything more public.
So if they're still sitting on tens of thousands of documents, there's no way the U.S. government can go in there through some cyber activity and just stop the servers or anything else?
I think we've got probably some great cyber people, but from what we can tell, WikiLeaks has been pretty good at how they're protecting the data that they have, that if there is a cyber attack, this stuff will be released somewhere else. It will get out.
You wrote a letter, and we have a copy here, to the Secretary of State Hillary Clinton and the Director of National Intelligence James Clapper, saying you want to know what's going on, and you're not getting access to information that the New York Times or Al Jazeera or others have.
Or 500,000 people in the military have. We'd like to know what's in these documents. What's coming down the pike? What vulnerabilities are there? What security issues may arise?
Why won't they share this information?
Because
you're the ranking member of the Intelligence Committee.
They're saying they won't share it because this is executive privilege. These are documents that are part of the discourse within the executive branch. So they will not provide it to us at this point. We're introducing a resolution on the floor of the House today, demanding that the president make these documents available to us. You know, if the New York Times and Der Spiegel has them, if WikiLeaks have them, why can't we see them?
Because it says here that only the Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, can give you access to this information. Have you called her? Have you asked her?
We've asked. I've not talked to her personally.
Maybe that would be a good idea.
Maybe that would be a great idea, yes.
Because she might be sensitive as a former legislator herself.
Right, and I think, and the thing on this is, Wolf, this is not a partisan issue. This is bipartisan. I think the Democrats on the committee also want to know what's in these documents. When you provide 500,000 access points into a data system, I bet there's 500,001 and 500,002 access points, one of which is the Russians and one of which is the Chinese.
But you want the left hand of the U.S. government to know what the right hand of the U.S. government knows so that the FBI and the CIA, they can share information. That came out of 9/11.
Yeah.
Should anyone lose his or her job as a result of this leak?
I think that there's probably a multitude of people who should.
Like who?
The person in State Department that said, we're going to give the database to the Defense Department without ever asking or demanding to know who was going to have access to the database. The person within the Department of Defense that said, we're getting all this information, we're going to look at it, we're not going to look at it, we're just going to put it all out there. And then probably the person that Private First Class Manning worked for,
who said, sure, it's okay to go in there with your thumb drive and play Lady Gaga music.
This is the allegation against
him. That's the allegation against him, yeah.
But this has been going on, presumably, the sharing of information between the State Department and the Pentagon, long before the Obama administration took office.
It's not a partisan issue. This system was created during the Bush administration. It affects, you know, both administrations, you know, the infrastructure, the bureaucracy was sloppy when it was put together, and you're right, it goes back, you know, 4 or 5 years.
Whether it was with what the Washington Post revealed about black sites in Central and Eastern Europe, or whether it's these WikiLeaks, we have a lot of allies that have taken big risks that now are embarrassed. Let me go to Mark Kirk. Mark, obviously you've got a background in military intelligence. You understand this as much as anybody. The question we've been asking all morning, I guess I need to start calling you Senator now.
Yes.
I'm sorry.
Well,
Senator Kirk. Senator Kirk.
More hours.
Yeah. How the hell does a private first class get access to the top State Department secrets, Pentagon secrets, war secrets? How does that happen?
I think as the media pointed out, he had access to what's called the CipherNet, and almost a million people do. They've been trying to push information out to combat units and other commands in a broad way, but did so without adequate protections. That's why I'm very interested in the announcement of Secretary Gates to further protect our secret data and make sure especially a massive download by one PFC couldn't happen again.
So you say that a million people have access to the information that this private had?
I think it was the New York Times that did a profile on the CipherNet, which PFC Manning had access to. And one of the questions I have is, while people can access individual messages related to their specific job, shouldn't this system have caught someone downloading 500,000 messages and asked him, what are you doing?
Yes, yes.
Mark, who would be responsible for following that traffic? Is that the State Department? Would it be the Pentagon? Where does the responsibility lie?
Secretary Gates and the Pentagon.
Okay. Well, I guess Secretary Gates and the Pentagon have a hell of a lot of questions to answer. That's a great point.
It's also the chain of command. Before you get to Secretary Gates, you get to some company commander who is in charge of Private First Class Bradley Manning.
I can't believe
right up the chain of command
this much.
To Hillary Clinton, keep fighting for us.
TeamHillaryClinton.com.